My name is Vitaly. I'm the developer of the new CAD feature in SprutCAM. And today I'm going to show you all the things you can do with it. In short, this CAD allows you to create parametric 3D models like those you can see on the screen. And those models you can use directly in SprutCAM as parts, fixtures, or workpieces. And the best way to demonstrate this feature is by an example. Today I'm going to demonstrate how to recreate the model you can see on the screen. This model from our examples by bound. This will be the first part of my demonstration, and the second part I will show you how to create a chuck model and to use it in SprutCAM. And the third part will be about how to use the .exe files and use the CAD feature to convert those files to a 3D model. Okay, let's start. We'll start by creating a new project, and to start designing, we click the design button. Now you are in the dedicated environment. If you have ever used SolidWorks or Fusion 360, you will feel at home. You can see three orthogonal planes you can start designing with. We just click one plane, the XY plane, and click the sketch button to create a sketch. Okay, let's me rotate the view. Now, the easiest way to start designing is by importing an image of the part we want to design. I prepared such an image in advance. Let's place it so that the left side of our part aligned with the origin. Okay, now we have to scale it so that the measurements of the part were as we want. We want them to be 200 millimeters in length, so we place the scaling center to the origin, then drag one point of the image and align the right side of the part with the mark 200 millimeters. Okay, now we will just use the contour tool and contour out the boundary of this image. We don't have to be precise while doing so, because later we can change the dimensions to the exact measurements. Okay. So we can use the trim tool to trim this cut, and we can align this line, make it vertical, or this line, make it vertical too. Okay, now let's add some roundings and chamfers we have on this part. We will use the rounding tool. Okay, here we have chamfers, we have chamfer here, and we have roundings here and here, and here we have some chamfers, I think. Okay, and we have a chamfer or rounding here and here, and also here and here. Okay, our CAD is fully parametric. It means that the sketch is driven by its dimensions, and you can change these dimensions at any moment in time. For example, I can change the dimensions of the chamfers I just created. Let's say they have to be 1.2 or 1 millimeter. Okay. And let's say the roundings has to be, have to be 1 millimeter also. And as you can see, all the roundings that are equal to the to those are also 1 millimeter in size. And I also can place the other dimensions to fully constrain this part. For example, I can say that the outer diameter has to be 90 millimeters. I've added this dimension and it's in radial, as radial dimension. To change it to a diametral dimension, I have to change the type of this line from construction to center line. Now you can see the dimension is a diameter and I can change it to 90 millimeters. Okay, and as you can see, the associated lines were moved. And like this, I can dimension all the part, but I'm not going to do it right now because it would take too much time. Let's move on. Let's move to 3D by exiting the sketch. We just press this button. Now we are in the 3D environment and all the closed areas of the sketch are now highlighted with the blue color. And if I click on this area, a toolbar appears where the options are extrude and revolve. We want to revolve this area around the rotary axis. We just click this button. And as you can see, we now have a body of revolution. Now let's create a cutout in the middle. To do so, we at first create a plane tangent to this cylinder and then create a sketch on this plane. Okay, now let's import some geometry from the part to the sketch. Let's import this plane and this plane. Let's try again. Okay, and now let's draw a line here. Now let's offset these lines. We just select one line, the other line, press Ctrl on the keyboard and drag the lines with the mouse. Now they are offset. We can change the distance, for example, to 4 millimeters. Okay, and now let's change the type of these lines to construction so they don't get in the way. Okay, and let's draw a line here to form the pocket and use the mirror tool to mirror this line relative to the central axis of the part. Okay, and let's fully constrain the sketch by adding the dimension between these lines. Let's say it be 20 millimeters. Now let's exit from the sketch and use this area to form the pocket. Let's drag this area down. Okay. One more time. I want to snap it to the geometry. So I want to catch the snap point. Okay. Where are the snap points? I don't see snap points. Okay, let's move on. Now, as we have only one pocket, we have to multiply it 6 times. To do so, we select the extrude feature in the tree and in the inspector below, you can see the pattern field here. We create a new pattern around. We will create a circular pattern around the central axis of the part. And we will use 6 numbers of repetition. Okay, now we have 6 pockets. Let's change the dimensions of the pocket. Okay. And as you can see, this area is no longer needed, so we can hide it in the by clicking this icon in the tree. And we can also hide this area here because it's no longer needed. Now let's create a holes. We just create another plane tangent to the cylinder and create a sketch on this plane. Now let's draw a circle, 6 millimeters in diameter, and exit the sketch and pull the circle down to create a hole and use the apparent feature around the rotary axis. And as before, the number around the axis is 6, and this time we have to multiply in two axes, one around the axis of revolution and the second time along the axis. So we mark this check, we check this box and put the number of repetition 3, then set the distance, let it be 20 millimeters, and press this button to say the holes have to be distributed both ways from the original hole. Okay. Now let's hide the area that is no longer needed. And to create the chamfers, we can use an axis plane and create a sketch on this axis plane. Now let's import a cylinder to this sketch and use the polygon tool to create a quad. So we put 4 in the count field and check the inscribed checkbox. And now we can draw the quad here. And let's fully constrain it by making this point coincidental to this line. Okay, now we can put the exact dimension, exit the sketch, and select this area and revolve it. Okay, as you can see, we created this piece of material, but we didn't want to add material. We wanted to remove material. And to do so, we just have to change the type of the Boolean operations from auto to remove. We click this button and now we have this chamfer, which is a conical surface. Okay, now let's hide this area. And now we have to multiply this feature. And to do so, we can use the existing part pattern we use for multiplying the holes. It's the pattern E2, which I selected from the combo box. And as you can see, we have the chamfers that are exactly positioned as the holes. Okay, and now all we have left to do is to create 4 pockets on this face. We just select this face and in the toolbar, click the sketch button. Now in the sketch, we will import this cylinder and draw a line here and use the mirror tool. We select this line and use the mirror tool to mirror it relative to the axis and draw the arc from this point to this point. Okay, and now let's fully constrain the sketch. Let's add the dimension from this line to this line. Let's say it would be 24 millimeters and add the dimension from this arc to the axis. Let it be 40 millimeters. Okay, and let's say the radius will be 32. And as you constrain the sketch, you can see the lines become bold. I think this line is thin and these two lines are bold, and this means that those two lines are fully constrained and this line is not. And to fully constrain it, we have to add one more constraint. We have to make this point coincident with the axis, so we use the tangent constraint. Okay, now we can add some roundings here and here. And that's it for the sketch. We exit and pull this area till it snaps to the next plane to create the pocket. And let's hide the areas. Okay, one problem we have. No, it's not a problem. It's the size of the, it has to be not 40, let's say it would be 30 millimeters. Okay, and let's multiply this extrusion. We use a new pattern around the rotary axis, and the number of repetitions would be 4. Okay, so now we created this part, we can go back to SprutCAM and go to machining tab, and we have the turn milling machine here, so we can use all the turning and milling operations to machine this part. For example, we can create an OD wrapping operation and calculate it, or we can create a roughing waterline operation to machine one of the pockets we have here. To do so, we have to change the tool connector from face drill to OD drill, and we have to change the tool diameter from 20 to say 8 millimeters. And let's add the face we want to machine to the job assignment. And we have to turn the part, sorry, we use the rotary axis, and to exactly position the part along the tool axis, we just click this plane, press OK, and add this plane as a pocket. Now we can just press run, and you can see the tool path is generated. And after you finish machining the part, you can simulate it, the tool path, on the machining tab. As you can see, there are a lot of exclamation marks and errors here, but the point of this video is not simulation, so we won't go in this thoroughly. Let's move on, and let's create the chuck we have here, or similar chuck. So let's create a new project and create a new design. I create a sketch on this plane and draw a contour of the chuck body. Let's use a rectangle tool and a contour of the jaw. Okay. Let's make something more complex like this. And exit the sketch. Now we click this area and create a revolution body, and this area we just drag with the mouse and use a symmetrical option to make it symmetrical to create a draw. Okay, as you can see, now it's only one body, and to make two bodies we have to change the type of the boolean operation or the extrude feature to new body. And now we have two parts here, one part one and part two. We can change the color, for example, of part one to red, and the color of part two to yellow. And we also can change the captions. Let's be the caption of part one be Chuck Buddy. And the caption of part two would be Joe. Okay. Let's make our model a little bit more realistic. So we want to create pockets for the Chuck where it can slide. So we just click on this face and create a tangent plane, then create a sketch on this plane and import a face of the bottom of the Chuck to the sketch. Now let's exit the sketch and pull this area down to create a pocket. Now let's hide the areas we no longer need and multiply this feature 3 times around the axis of the Chuck. Okay, so this is our Chuck. We can go back to our sketch and make our model a little bit more real by adding some chamfers like here or rounding here, maybe here, something like this. Or we can add some dimensions. Okay, let's change the type of this line to center line and add a dimension from this line to an outer diameter of the Chuck. So now we can change the size to say 360. Okay, let's say our model is finished. Now to use it in SprutCAM as a fixture, we have to convert it to a fixture model. So we go to the machining tab, and on this tab we go to the fixture tab. Okay, let's now we have a machine that already has a Chuck. So let's just change it to something that doesn't have a Chuck so it didn't confuse you, like an abstract machine. Now let's go to the fixture tab, and here we have a few options. The first option is add Chuck, so we're gonna use it. We press the add Chuck button, expand the Chuck node, and on the body node we click the add faces button, and in this window we select our Chuck body, press add to specify the faces of the Chuck body. And now let's do the same with the jaws, and let's hide the geometry model so it doesn't get in the way. Okay, as you can see, we made a Chuck, and this Chuck is alive. For example, you can drag the jaws and they would move, and you can save this Chuck to the library by using this save button. Let's put a name for our Chuck. It would be Chuck 360. Okay, and this Chuck is available in all new projects. For example, we can create a new project and go to fixtures and press load, and here you can see all the fixtures we have. And the first option is our new Chuck 360. We just press it, this option, and the Chuck model is loaded to the project and it's alive. For example, you can create, let's create a new design and make a simple project like this. Let's create a simple revolution body, and machine it. Okay. Sorry. Let's put the visibility of the check on. And using the workpiece setup option, we just move the part here. And now we can move the jaws so that would fix our part. And now let's create something like a 3D wrapping waterline operation and calculate it. And our workpiece is a simple box. So the generated toolpath avoids our fixtures. And we can even specify the stock for our fixture. For example, okay, I forgot how to do it, sorry. What is it? Probably not. Okay, but you got the point. We can use our check we have created in design in all our projects. And we can go back to 3D model, and our check is in the fixture model folder. And here we can just press the edit button. And in the design, we can change the measurements of our check. For example, we can just drag this face to reduce the diameter, or this face, or put the exact measurements in the fields. And this is pretty neat, I think. And after that, when you recalculate the toolpath, all the changes are reflected in the toolpath. And we can simulate, for example. Okay, so that was for the second topic. Okay, sorry. It is a developer version, so some errors might arise. Let me start again. And one last thing I wanted to show is how to convert DXF files using the CAD feature. For example, in our examples, we have some file, EDM3DM. It was created in Rhinoceros, but it is a wire geometry file. And let's say we want to convert it into a 3D model. To do so, we just right click on the item in the tree. And here we have an option called Convert to Design. We choose it. And now you can convert the curves to a 3D model simply by pulling the areas up or down like this. And after that, you can use regular operations in SprutCAM to machine this part. Sorry. Why? There is no toolpath. Because the part is empty. I created the parts in this folder. So I just drag it to the part, and now I can machine it. Okay. And for example, I can also edit this model and create a workpiece. I just click here, select the outer bound and use the offset tool to create an offset. Now I go to 3D and drag this face, for example, snap to the top face of the part and put a stock here, like 3 millimeters, and use the new body option and name this part as a workpiece. And I can even put some chamfers, roundings here, like this. And now I can use this model as a workpiece. I just go to machining and at the workpiece tab, press the faces button and use this model. And now we have, and our part we have to update here. We remove the part because it has both the part and the works now. So we just remove this folder and add the part one as our part. Now we can do machining.